My name is Jan Pohl. I'm in charge of the biotechnology core facility at the Centers for Disease Control. My role in MaHPIC is to direct proteomics core, one of the major laboratory cores on the MaHPIC. Basically we'll be analyzing protein profiles related to the project. The bottom line perspective, we think that especially on the surface of red blood cell membranes, we will see potentially some candidates for biomarkers. We can later on focus on these and eventually design even some assays long term, if you know they are validated, if they have relevance to the biology or pathophysiology. As a protein chemist, I'm interested in host defense mechanism, in mechanism of innate immunity. I've worked for years in the area of human antimicrobial proteins, but they also turn out to have activity against parasites, especially in the area of lower molecular weight, smaller proteins or even peptides. And those may have potential, you know, for even therapeutics. So it's important that these peptides are not only recognized now as antimicrobial, but they also have a host defense function. So they would be like, could be viewed like one of the first layers of defense against invading pathogens. Well, the systems biology approach basically builds on reductionist pieces where we go out and get a detailed analysis of subsystems. And systems biology people are able to take these hopefully well curated data on subsystems and, you know, build a bigger picture. But it's going to be always built, what a very important part of system biology is to get highly accurate data on a smaller focused area, like one or two pathways and so on. Because without highly curated, highly reliable data, you cannot build good models. I think that the potential is for surveillance, getting better molecular tools for surveillance. Those that are not available these days, with, you know, far-reaching, refined ways to look at pathogen spread, either, you know, at a current or even retroactive examination of population exposure and so on. Use protein-based tools that have a very unique character in terms of being immunologically still relevant after, let's say, infection is gone. Population still has, of course, these markers, but also proactively being able to, let's say, even in the field, to quickly diagnose. Especially in malaria, the problem is, for example, with low carrier subpopulation where clinical symptoms are not immediately revealed. Being able to work with a variety of groups with overlapping but unique expertise, to be able to exchange ideas and focus, especially in field, in the omics field, that's very important to be able to focus on what is important, since everyone is generating huge data sets and so on, but at some point you will be able to, or you should be able to reduce data, focus, either confirm hypotheses, create a new one and so on. High density data is very hard to manipulate, very hard to comprehend, even for the human mind, display of data, presentation and so on. So it's very important that systems biology will create hypotheses, but then we probably will have to go back to somewhat more reductionist approach and take one protein at a time and, you know, one pathway and so on. That's how usually drugs work and so on. So
okay.
Still, we need to keep in mind that current diagnosis, let's say protein-based diagnosis, it's only about 220 protein assays for all diseases of the approved. And 95% of them are probably single protein based. So it's going to continue like that. But I think that this systems biology approach will hopefully help us design new assays, perhaps even multi-target assays, which is a major problem these days for more complicated diseases.